is heavy.
Okay, but I'm not going to pay you the same rate as for solitary.
How much?
$3.
$5 is half the going rate.
All right, $5. That's $8 altogether. I'll go and get it.
Hey, Faye. $5 and $5 is $10, not $8.
Good. What happened?
I just had a little visit from your mate, B. Smith. Don't pass out on me now. I'm gonna need your help.
I'm sorry. I was gonna be sick. What's it supposed to be? Okay?
Yeah.
The killer.
Well, it's not for kisses. Come on, give us a hand. I've got to put something on it.
Yeah, I'll go and get the sister.
Oh, you off your head? What am I supposed to say, that I burnt myself ironing?
What can I put on it? I could get some butter from the kitchen or something.
Oh, shut up, will you? Just get a hanky, some cold water, and drip it on real slow.
Now, don't blame me if this hurts.
Do it! Now.
Just saw Lizzie, and she reckons Favo hoed into her real good. Would have sent her to solitary except for a ticker. Instead, she's been confined to her cell.
Well, how long for?
Dunno. But Lizzie's not too cut up about it. She reckons she's got a lot of insurance coming her way.
Well, you reckon Faye will pay her the same as if she was in the pound?
Half. Well, that's what Lizzie reckons. Hey, where is everybody?
Faye's off with the basket, and I don't know where B is. Are you back with us? Because we could use a hand.
Yeah, beats clean and dirty dunnies. Insurance don't pay enough for that. Hey, you reckon B'd mind if I had a go at the press?
Yes, B would.
You okay? Don't look too crash-hot.
Well, I'm not. I don't want to talk about it.
Why not?
I said I don't want to talk about it.
Are you sure that's all you want to put on it? Wet hankies?
Yeah. It'll be all right. It'll stop my clothes sticking to the burn.
Oh, yuck. Don't talk about it.
Come on. We better get out of here before some screw starts nosing around.
Yeah, I've got to get that basket back to the laundry.
Yeah. And don't forget that little present for B. Smith. With my compliments.
I've got it.
What are you doing here, Quinn?
Nothing, Mrs. Morris.
Thought you might be checking on Mackenzie. Is she all right?
Well, yeah, why wouldn't she be?
I heard she wasn't well. Mrs. Powell told me.
I'm okay. It's no big deal.
I've got to get back to the laundry, Mrs. Morris. Excuse me.
I'll get on with my work too.
What's up with her?
Don't know. But if you don't want to talk, it's best not to push your luck.
Suits me. About time. We've been waiting for that.
Yeah, where the hell have you been anyhow?
It's gonna scar, B.
Good. No point otherwise.
What are you two talking about?
Shall I tell him? Well, come on, what's going on?
We got Nola.
Yeah? About time.
She burnt her.
Burn her? Well, how do you mean?
With a soldering iron. She branded her.
Any complaints?
Hey, B, is this for real?
Oh, yeah. It's for real, all right. Mackenzie got a little souvenir, compliments of Paddy. A nice big K for killer.
Should have seen it. It was horrible. Burnt right through her skin. Oh, ripper!
Yeah, it was about time that bitch got what was coming to her.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to kill her.
Oh, you'd like that better, would you? Well, you listen to me. This is a lot better. Every time she looks at that, she's going to be reminded of what she did to Paddy. And that's what we wanted, wasn't it? Well, wasn't it?
Insurance money. I promised to bring it to you this morning.
Yeah, I know. When I got back to my cell, there was Nola. Feet burnt her really badly with the soldering iron.
Go on. Well, it's about time that Nola got her comeuppance.
Yeah, but they branded her. It was awful, Lizzie. I could smell the burnt flesh.
Yeah, well, I got no sympathy for her. She deserves everything she gets, and B knows better. Now, listen, where's my money? Because I got to go back into confinement this
afternoon. I'll get it for you. I'll promise.
I thought you were confined to yourself.
Well, my lad out from me is Dave's orders. Is it true, B, that you put that Nola in her place?
Hey, how did you find out so soon?
Nothing happens around here she doesn't know about. Got a nose like a ferret.
Well, I'm really glad that you had a go at her, B.
Well, well, well. Speak of the devil.
I reckon she knows who's boss got me now.
Maybe.
Don't you want any, Tucker?
I can live without it. Yeah. How's the insurance going? Selling any?
How can you talk about things like that after what's happened?
It's happened. Finished. Let her continue being top dog for a while longer. That's not important. I'm going to tie up all the money in this place, lock, stock and barrel. That's what's important. By the time I've finished with this lot, they're going to be coming to me. Not Mrs. Top Dog Smith.
Hi, love.
Hi.
I fixed you up some sandwiches.
Oh, good. That's probably all I've got time for anyway.
I was hoping that we could have that talk now. You do want to talk,
yes.
Don't you?
I'm here, okay? Though I honestly don't see how it can do any good.
Oh, come on, love. We could always talk. Besides, you can't turn your back on what we've had for 16 years.
Well, that's just the point. Whatever we've had, we seem to have lost somewhere along the way. I'd get it back if I could, but I don't know how.
Oh, don't say that, love. Make it sound as though it's all your fault.
It is nobody's fault. Just happened.
Look, you've been under a big strain, love. I understand.
Oh, for God's sakes, don't be so damn understanding. Can't you see it is no good between us anymore?
No.
Yes! And face it. I have to. I don't like it any more than you do. I feel like a stranger every time I walk in here now. I can't communicate with my own children. Things between you and I, well, they've never been worse. As a wife and a mother, I'm just not equipped for the job anymore.
It's that rotten prison, isn't it? You come home here tired and cranky. Why don't you just give it away?
Live on your salary. Don't make me laugh.
I do me best.
No, you don't. Okay, okay. Look, you don't have any ambition and you're content with your lot. That's fair enough. Oh, but God, let's not pretend that we could live on your money, because you know it's not true. We need my money to live. Oh, and I need my job for my sanity.
Your sanity? Meaning having me and the kids isn't enough for you? Right?
Yes, right. Oh, see? I didn't want to have to say these things to you. I don't want to hurt you.
So what do we do?
I don't know. Wish I did. Really do.
Hey, do you reckon they're going to have a go at each other?
Don't know. But if they do, I'm going to find a nice quiet corner and sit it out. I've done my bit.
Hey, Quinn. This insurance scheme of yours.
Yeah?
Would you fork out if someone got done over by one of us?
Geez, I don't know. It's only supposed to be for getting punished by the screws.
Pity. I'm beginning to think that some of you might need a little protection around here from now on.
Screws are still the biggest headache we got.
Don't you bet on it. I haven't even started yet. How much would it set me back?
$2.
All right. I'll buy in. The way the screws have been watching me, they're bound to catch me in action. Very soon.
Maybe I'll tell Lizzie that I got her a job as a mature age model for flannel and underwear. That'll shut her up.
Well, you can hardly blame her for wanting to talk to you. After all, she hasn't got anybody on the outside.
Yeah, poor soul. Well, maybe I'll have a bit more luck with Bea. I shouldn't have any trouble getting her work release.
You sure you can handle this? I mean, I don't mean the job. Obviously, you can do that standing on your head. But you've already got a terribly heavy workload.
Yeah, I know. Well, the department haven't been exactly quick off the mark. Getting a replacement for Tony Berman, I'll have to speak to them about it.
Hasn't Helen been helping you?
Oh, yeah, but I don't want to press my luck or our friendship.
Mrs. Morris. Oh, hello, Judy.
Hi, Miss Stetson.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything. I was looking for Mrs. Powell's new rosters.
I think Heather's got them already.
Oh, good. Now that you're here, Judy, perhaps you could help us. There's something very odd going on amongst the women.
Isn't there always?
Not like this. They're getting into trouble over little things, and they don't seem at all concerned when they're punished, not even when they lose their buyer privileges. It's almost as though they welcome it.
Well, that doesn't sound right.
Well, as you're going to be working so closely with them, I thought perhaps you...
Now, just a minute, Mrs. Davidson. If you gave me this job just so that I could report on the women, you're barking up the wrong tree. There is no way I will lag on them.
I would never ask you to betray a trust. It's just that they're harming themselves, and I'm sure none of us want that.
Yeah, well, I see what you mean, but the women are my friends. I'd never do anything that would hurt them.
I can appreciate that.
Well, all right, maybe, if it's something really big, but only if it'll help them, huh? Agreed?
Agreed. Thank you.
I'll let you know as soon as I find somewhere.
Colleen, please, we can work it out here.
No, we can't.
Look, what is it I've done wrong? Tell me. Look, I'll change.
Please.
If you just...
Don't do that. Please. Look, if we have some time away from each other, we might be able to see things more clearly. I'm not saying it's forever, but I do need time on my own to think about it.
What about the kids? What am I going to tell them?
I'll tell them. As best I can. Try not to worry.
Worry? But where are you going? When am I going to see you?
I don't know. Please, I need to be on my own.
Cole.
I'm sorry.
Hey, you're a bit jumpy. Have I come on a bad day, or am I just wearing the wrong deodorant?
Oh, of course not. It's a real treat to see you. Honey, I don't want any sticky beaks. See, I'm supposed to be confined to my cell.
What for?
Nothing. I tried to get into trouble with Davo, but all I got was loss of remission. So I had to tell the others that Davo was punishing me so that I could collect.
Now, hang about, Lizzie. You've lost me 5 miles back. Collect what?
Me insurance money. See, you pay your premium and then you get a payout every time you cop it from the screws. That's what Faye told me.
So that's what it's all about, huh? But Faye Quinn, I didn't think she was cluey enough to come up with that one.
Yeah, well, you learn pretty fast in a place like this. You ought to remember that.
Yes, and thank God I don't have to cope with it anymore. Anyway, what about Bea? I know how she felt about Patty. Is she keeping away from Mackenzie?
Hardly. And you wait till you hear what Bea did to her.
You must have had a nice lunch. Know what time it is?
I think you could count the number of times I've been laid on one hand.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean anything.
No. Well, my life just doesn't revolve around this damn place.
And Bea reckons it's a reminder of what she did to Patty for the rest of her life.
God. Still, I suppose it's better than killing her. You reckon Bea will be satisfied now and lay off her?
Come off it, Jude. Even if Bea did lay off, that ratbag Nola's bound to have another go. Only good thing you could say about her was she didn't go run to the screws. But she's gonna be after Bea's blood, and that's for sure.
Yeah, well, I suppose you're right. But one thing's for certain. If I know Bea, this is only the beginning. Yeah, well, I'll check out a few places and get back to you. But I still think you ought to go with the hairdressing. I mean, you're qualified for that.
Yeah, sounds okay to me.
Listen, what's this I hear about an insurance scheme? I don't think that Quinn could have masterminded that.
No, me neither. She had another brain to be lonely. This is much too involved.
Yeah, sounds more like the freak's work to me.
That's what I reckon, too. But I haven't had time to check it out. I've had other things on my mind.
Yeah. Is it over?
Is what over?
Now, come on, you know what I'm talking about. Mackenzie.
This is none of your business, Jude.
Of course it's my business. I mean, I'm one of you, aren't I?
No, you're not. You're out now. You're a mate. But you're not one of us. So just do yourself a favour and butt out, will you?
Well, come on, fill her up. Told you before, you're too slow.
Well, it's not very often we have a chance for a quiet drink, is it?
Come on.
Oh, would you look at that. So much for our quiet drink. Hello, Hazel.
Well, what do you know? You never know you're going to run into when you're having a nice little drink, do you?
Well, only the best people drink here, Hazel.
That's right. You did right, only the very, very best. So, what do you have?
I'm sorry, darling. Jenny, I know, I'm being unfair. I'm asking an awful lot of you, but please try and understand. Well, oh, I don't know. It might only be for a few days. No, don't. Come on, darling. Don't cry. Everything is going to be all right, you'll see. Oh, of course I love you. Yes, Robert as well. I'll drop around after school and see you one day, all right? All right. Listen, you be careful, won't you? I love you.
Mrs. Powell, have you seen those requisition forms I was looking at this morning?
No, I'm sorry. Here are the reports I've already finished.
Is everything all right?
Yeah. I think I'm a bit tired. Oh, it's just about time for you to go home, isn't it?
Judy, I really don't.
It's all right, I understand. I can handle this.
What's that?
You're off, Mrs. Morris.
Yes, I'm afraid I have to go, Hazel.
Are you sure you can
Yes, manage? Yes, she'll be all right once she gets some food in her.
Bye.
Bye, Mrs. Morris.
Okay, kid, we're going home.
Home? No, I'm not going.
I am going to take you home and make you something to eat.
You got any booze?
Now, you know the rules, but I got some nice hot coffee.
No. Sorry, Jude. I said I'm going to go and stay with some mates.
What mates?
Just mates. Anyhow, you don't want me around.
Listen, Hazel, if you want to feel sorry for yourself, why don't you just do it at home? Now, I am not leaving without you.
Screws still think I'm sick. Oh, what a lurk. Old Faye'll be going bankrupt.
Oh, no, she won't. Not till she pays me. I'm going for the big one.
What?
Solitary. I reckon I can handle it if there's $10 waiting for me.
You lucky little bugger. They won't put me in the pan.
Well, you don't have to, Lizzie, because you've got this lurk going. But $10 is $10.
Yeah, well, this is about $10.
You haven't seen that much in a month of Sundays.
Oh, we were just talking about Faye's insurance.
Oh.
Yeah, but seeing you don't belong, I don't suppose you're very interested.
That's right, and I'll tell you why. Because either you're all going to end up flat broke, or Faye is going to end up handing out IOUs. And either way, it doesn't bother me. Just so long as no one gets hurt.
She's not here.
Oh, will she be back soon?
She's gone, Meg. Left me.
What?
She came home at lunchtime, packed her case and just left. What am I going to tell the kids?
What on earth happened?
I don't know. What's happening to her, Meg? Why doesn't she want to live with us anymore?
Morning. You all right?
I'm fine. Why shouldn't I be?
I called into your house to see you last night. Yes, well, yesterday you seemed so... Anyway, I just called in to see you.
And I suppose Patrick told you.
Yeah. Just can't believe it. Patrick's devastated. He just doesn't seem to know which way to turn.
Neither do I. God. Trust him to broadcast it to the whole world.
Oh, Colleen, that's not fair.
Look, one of us had to do it. And he certainly isn't strong enough to make the first move for himself.
You sure you thought this through?
I've thought about nothing else for months. Last night was the first time I slept in ages. I know. Sounds callous, doesn't it? But surely that means something.
From the look of Patrick, I don't think he would have slept at all.
Well, there's no way I can make it any easier for him. As soon as he gets over the initial shock, he'll realise it's the best thing for both of us.
Hey, Mackenzie, why don't you get your gear off? You got nothing we ain't seen before.
Maybe she's shy.
Oh, dear,
that's enough. I'm not in the mood this morning.
Hey, what's where you going?
Listen, Daniels.
Well, she pushed me, and no one pushes me around. And don't go off at me just because you're in a crabby mood.
I have had enough of you, Daniels.
Get nodded.
Well, you've just landed yourself in solitary. Mrs. Davidson, I'll confirm it when she gets in.
Yeah?
Watch those three.
It's going to cost you $10, babe. I hope you weren't planning to retire.
shut up.
Yes, Mrs. Cowell. Oh, great, I was getting a bit peckish. You've forgotten something.
Yeah, what?
Me $10. I've got to have something to cheer me up while I'm locked away from me mates.
Yeah, I figured you'd want it. I don't know why, but there's nothing to spend it on in here.
Yeah, well, at least I can look at it a lot. Make the time go faster.
What'd you have to go and get Po-Face a mouthful of cheap for? She'd have let you off if you hadn't done that.
Yeah, I'm real sorry about that, Faye. Must have just lost me head. Always did have a big mouth.
Well, put a sock in it next time. You're costing me money.
Yeah, I will. Sorry.
If you want to spend some time here, I'm sure I can find a room for you.
I'm coming, Mrs. Powell.
Don't you turn up in the choicest places.
Well, how you been?
Bought yourself first style for formal occasions, eh?
This is Spike. He's me mate. Found him out the back door this morning. Poor little pussy.
Boy, he's been teaching you some bad habits. What'd you two have for breakfast?
Spike had milk. Didn't you, Spike? Mm.
Well, I think it's really nice of Spike to come in and see you, but visiting hours are over. Come on.
Ah, he's mine. He's got no one same as me. I can talk to him.
Okay, Hayes, you know it's against the rules. Now, the cat has got to go before Judy gets home.
Yeah, all right. Take him, then. Everyone takes away the things I love. Why shouldn't you?
Hazel, you've got to pull yourself together. You can't go on like this.
Why? No one gives a stuff anyhow.
Now, that's not true, but even if it were, that's no reason to destroy yourself.
Well, it's my money, and if I want to spend it on booze, it's my business.
Well, you might as well send it down the drain. Where's all this bread coming from, anyway?
Well, at least I don't get it flat in my back like some people I could mention.
Oh, Spike, your friend's got big problems. Big problems.
Still doing here?
Oh, I'm still feeling a bit crook. Yeah, Mrs. Powell. Oh, that Mrs. Davidson got me confined on account of me nicking stuff out of the kitchen.
Confined? That's the first I've heard of it. Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. You don't think I'd be here by choice, do you?
Do you want something?
Oh, yeah, dirty towels. Somebody forgot to put these out this morning.
Hi, Toots. Well, hello there. When did you get here?
After breakfast. God, it's been a long day. But somehow I couldn't tear myself away from the glamour of it all.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Any mail?
If you mean Laurie, not a dicky bird. There's a few window panes for you to sift through there.
Yeah, I guess she has her hands full at the moment, huh?
Oh, yes. The simple joys of motherhood. Saints preserve me.
Well, thanks for holding the fort, love.
Ah, don't mention it. You'll get my bill at the end of the month, though maybe I should be paying you. I didn't exactly do an earth-shaking job. Look.
Oh, my God, what's that?
Well, rumor has it that's a cat. Her name is Spike, and she's purebred Ally.
She?
Yes, well, maybe we should rename her Spikeette. Mm.
A female cat. We will have every Randy Tom surrounding the place.
Oh, lucky Spikeette.
Now, be serious. You know the rules.
Sure I do. And I told them to our drunken friend here. I even tried to put the rotten thing out. But that did not last long. I tell you, this is bigger than Romeo and Juliet. She won't part with it.
Well, I'm afraid she's not going to have any choice. Come on, puss.
So, still feeling off colour, Lizzie?
Oh, yes, Mrs. M, real bad.
And that's because Mrs. Davidson confined you to your cell, is it?
Ah, reckon Mrs. Powell told you.
For God's sake, Lizzie, how did you think you could get away with lying to an officer?
I don't know. I mean, well, I thought Mrs. Davidson told me to stay in my cell and That's what made me feel cruel. See?
All right. Now, I don't know what game you're playing, but it's over. If you don't report for work tomorrow, you'll have to have a very good reason or a doctor's certificate.
Doctor's... Oh, you're pulling my leg, Mr. Sam.
No, I'm not, Lizzie. It's got to stop.
Does that mean I'm going to be punished for this?
No, not this time. But don't make a habit of it.
Oh, no, Mrs. M.
Oh, this is room 17. Yes, Mrs. Powell. Look, I'd like to book a table, please. Oh, say about an hour? Yeah. No, no, just for one, thanks.
Table for two?
No, for one, please. Sorry, after you.
I booked a table for one.
A name, please.
Mrs. Powell.
Just a minute, please. Well, we're pretty busy. We've got a large party coming in at 9. Would you be prepared to share?
I did book.
I wouldn't mind.
Madam?
No, no, no. I suppose that'll be okay.
If you'd rather not.
No, no, no. Sure, it'll be fine.
This way, please.
Thank you.
Would you care to order a drink?
Yes, please. Gin and tonic.
Make that two and put them on my tab.
No, I'm sorry, I can't allow you to do that.
That's the least I can do for letting me share your table.
Hardly my table.
Well, suppose we agree then. Our table. My name's Malcolm Hutchins.
Colin Powell.
Mm.
Would you like...
Sorry, I don't use them.
You want?
Are you on holidays or business?
No, actually, I'm in the process of moving house, so I'm staying here at the hotel. I work at Wentworth, the prison.
In administration?
No, I'm the deputy governor.
You know, it's always fascinated me, the penal system. Do you think it's the system's responsibility to rehabilitate or merely punish? I'm sorry, I'm going to bore you with a lot of questions.
No, really, it's all right. Quite used to them, really.
No, I really should thank you.
What for?
Sharing a table with me. Sometimes eating alone can be a very lonely experience, don't you think?
Come on, Hayes. We haven't had a chance to talk all day.
I thought you said all you had to say when you threw Spike out.
You're not still mad about that, are you? I gave the cat a saucer of milk. Pretty well fed to me anyway. Probably belongs to some kid. Now, you wouldn't want that on your mind, stealing some kid's pet, would you?
Suppose you'd be chucking me out next.
Now, that's not true and you know it. I want you to stay here. Hayes, I know you've had some bad breaks, but if you try and help yourself, I'll help you all I can.
I can look after myself.
Oh, yeah, sure. Last time you were in here, you helped yourself so much you ended up back in jail.
Yeah. Well, I don't plan on getting into any trouble this time.
Well, if you don't lay off the booze, you won't be conscious enough to know whether you're in trouble or not.
Well, you tell me. What else have I got?
That's my whole point, honey. All we've got to do is find something to interest you long enough to get you off the booze.
Yeah, don't hold your breath. Things don't always go according to a plan.
Really sorry.
So am I. Sorry I couldn't help you forget a few of your problems for a little while.
Well, that would take too long. And I don't think you've got that much time.
Unfortunately, I don't think I have either. Good night.
I wish I'd known last night you were just down the way. I could have kept you company.
I don't think I could have coped with company last night.
Oh, anyway, I reckon dinner tonight more than compensated. Here, let me top up your glass.
Oh, no, really, I've had enough. Besides, I have to work tomorrow and it is getting late.
Oh, I don't exactly have a long drive back to my room.
Malcolm.
Oh, it's been a great evening. No reason why we couldn't make an even better night. What's wrong?
I'm just not ready for this yet. I know what you must be thinking.
Oh, no, Colleen, it's all right. And you're wrong about what I'm thinking. I knew all evening you had something worrying you.
You said we was going to make heaps out of this.
So we will. All we got to do is to build up our stocks a bit.
You can say that again. We got practically nothing left. And if we have to start paying out in cash rather than goods, then we'll be really down the drain. Why don't we get some more stuff tossed over the fence?
Mm-mm. It's not worth the risk. We can't afford the chance of a screw turning around at the wrong moment. No. What we have to do is build up our bank. And the best way to do that is expand. We're going to start our insurance scheme in the other blocks. And if we need someone for collections and payouts, we'll pay them a commission.
Yeah,
we'll get the money rolling in. We still need some goods to trade, but money's no good if you can't buy nothing.
You're not wrong. That's why we're going to have to do an inside job and get all that we need.
Oh, bugger. Inside job?
Yeah. Where do we know around here that's piled high with goodies?
Storeroom?
Give the lady a cigar.
Yes?
Meg, it's Colleen.
Colleen, what are you doing here?
I hope you don't mind. I wasn't sure if you'd still be up.
No, of course not. Like a coffee?
Mm-hmm. Love it. Gee, you've got this looking really good.
Yes, well, it suits me. Now, what have you been up to tonight?
If I told you, I don't think you'd believe me.
No, I am interested.
I went to the restaurant and the hotel for dinner and ended up sharing my table with this man.
Colleen, don't tell me you let yourself be picked up.
Of course not. The restaurant was crowded. We had to share a table.
Well, what's so unbelievable about that?
Oh, we got to talking, had a few drinks. Then he showed me back to my room.
Ah. Well, I don't think I want to hear those details.
That's my point. There aren't any details. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know where to look. What is wrong with me?
Absolutely nothing. You've only been away from Patrick for 2 nights.
Well, I just didn't expect to feel so isolated. I have slept with the one man for 16 years. The thought of going to bed with someone else for the first time terrified me.
Well, it takes quite some time before you think of yourself as an individual.
Oh, the rate I'm going. Chances are I'll make a mess of that as well. I know I've got to stick with it. I've got to. I hate all the misery it's causing. If I could, I don't know, just put it right, make it easier.
Couldn't find a fine drink in this dummy you'd die. Fags. Spike? Hey, Spike, is that you? Oh, I knew you'd come back, my little sweetheart. Spike?
The roses here.